anything I want. Welcome in the name of Jesus, the Savior of the world. We are gathered to worship, to proclaim Christ crucified and risen, to remember before God our sister Martha, to give thanks for her life, to commend her to our merciful Redeemer, and to comfort one another in our faith. When we were baptized in Christ Jesus, we were baptized into his death. We were buried, therefore, with him by baptism into death, so that as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we shall certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. Eternal God, maker of heaven and earth, who formed us from the dust of the earth, who by your breath gave us life, we glorify you. Jesus Christ, the resurrection and life, who suffered death for all humanity, who rose from the grave to open the way to eternal life, we praise you.
We praise you.
Holy Spirit, author and giver of life, the comforter of all of sorrow, our sure confidence and everlasting hope, we worship you.
We worship you.
To you, O blessed Trinity, we glory and honor forever and ever.
Amen.
We sing together our opening song, Love Divine, All Else in Seven.
Thank you.
grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you today our sister Martha. We thank you for giving her to us to know and to love as a companion in our privilege on earth. Your boundless compassion and soulless warmth, give us faith to see that death has been swallowed up in the victory of our Lord Jesus Christ, so that we may live in confidence and hope until by your call we are gathered to our heavenly home in the company of all your saints. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. You may be seated. At this time, there's a sharing of personal remembrance.
Compliment from Patty and me all the way down to the grandkids. I did ask the grandchildren some of their favorite memories of Grand. And the things that came up the most were the 3 o'clock snack, no matter where we were, we made it to Grand's house for a 3 o'clock snack, and then the haircuts. Trisha also reminded me of the time when she was about 3 years old. She misbehaved in church, and Granny took her outside to discipline her. To which Trish said, "Listen, Grandma, even the birds are mad at you." Mom could only laugh. Peter wrote a song called Hun and Margie, which was their terms for each other. And that was the only words to the song, but we would all laugh hysterically when he broke into song. Nick remembers math flashcards. It wasn't all fun and games at Grammy's. Chris remembered the haircuts. Mom would line the boys all up and start cutting hair. Dad would supervise. It never failed that Dad would point out something wrong with one of the haircuts, and Mom would say, "Oh no, I botched it." Of course, that made all the boys laugh. The great-grandchildren's memories were more about talking to her, going shopping, learning new things from her, like baking and knitting, and of course, they all miss the hugs. And then there's not good yards at Christmas. And then there is her great-great-grandson, Emmett. And according to Mom, he is the cutest and smartest baby ever. Mom, you didn't botch it. Your legacy is your family that you shaped by your example to have faith in God, to care for others, to work hard, to celebrate life's blessings, and to go without complaining the extra mile. We were blessed to have you as a mom and grandma. We love you.
Thank you.
A reading from Proverbs. A capable wife, who can find? She is far more precious than jewels. Strength and dignity are her clothing, and she laughs at the time to come. She opens her mouth with wisdom, and the teaching of kindness is on her tongue. She looks well to the ways of her household, and does not eat the bread of idleness. Her children rise up and call her happy. Her husband too, and he praises her. Many women have done excellently, but you surpass them all. Charm is deceitful, and beauty is vain. But a woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. We stand to welcome the gospel. Proverbs claims. you also experience the margin of the truth. Look good, feel good, which you recently demonstrated to me, making the effort to get all dressed up for my visit with her just a few days before she died. From her, you were gifted with so much love and care. You were happy to return that love and care when she needed it. Although it was a joy to do so, giving care is also tiring. In this way, not only is the promise of rest and refuge for the weary for March, it is for you who loved and cared for her. She is now, as she always had been, in God's faithful care, held the promise of resurrection on the last day, when with all the blessed dead, she will be raised to life in the new creation of God. Entrusting her into this hope and promise frees us to rest, releases us from our own weariness, and allows us space to grieve as we need to, and to give thanks for Marge's life, all she needs to us. Held in the promise of the weary find rest in Jesus, supporting one another in this time of grief and remembering, trusting the future that God has in store for Marge, all of us, we give thanks to God, who gifted our lives with a woman of surpassing excellence, who showed us such dignity, strength, care, and love. We commend her to the rest promised all of the saints. We look forward to the day when we will be reunited with her and one another, the world made new, where unwearied and well-rested, we will enjoy life together again. Thanks be to God for this promised rest and future. And blessed be the memory of Martha Frances Martinson, alive among us. We sing together, "Be now, be thou my vision." us God's people through our baptism into Christ. Living together in trust and hope, we confess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified by the Holy Spirit, he descended into heaven. On the third day he rose again, he ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. Pray, God of mercy, hear our prayer. Almighty God, in holy baptism you have knit your chosen people together into one communion of saints in the body of Christ. Give to your whole church your light and your peace. God of mercy, grant that all who have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection may die to sin and rise to share in the new life in Christ. God of mercy, give courage and faith to all mourn, and assure and certain hope in your loving care. The casting mother's sorrow on you, they may have strength for the days ahead. God of mercy, grant to us who are still in our pilgrimage and who walk as yet by faith, that where this world groans in grief and pain, your Holy Spirit may lead us to bear witness to your light and life. God of mercy, help us, in the midst of things we cannot understand, to believe and trust in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to life everlasting. God of mercy, God of all grace, we give you thanks because by his death our Savior Jesus Christ destroyed the power of death. By his resurrection, he opened the kingdom of God to all. Make us certain that because he lives, we shall live also, and that neither death nor life, nor things present nor things to come, will be able to separate us from your love in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thank you. Might you stand as we're able? Let us together commend Martha Francis to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. To your hands, merciful Savior, we commend your servant Martha Francis. Acknowledge we humbly beseech you, sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen. Together we go in peace, singing, "Abide with me."